Welcome to another update on the 64 bypass project that loops traffic around south of Asheboro. As I was coming up 49 into Asheboro this morning, I noticed that work has begun north of the highway, and thought, well, I'll come over here to my friends at Jayco, the Jayco plant. They let me fly up from their parking lot. So we're going to take a look over here to the right, which is kind of north, and we'll see where several earth-moving pieces of equipment are out here working away. Now this is one rocky hill that they're working all in and around. Looks to me like it's going to be a lot of work to put a highway right through all those rocks. Going to be a lot of blasting away of the rocks to break it up and get it to where they can get the elevation the way they need it. The more I do these updates and fly over the different areas where the bypass is going, over at 64 and here at 49 and down 42, I see all this equipment, this company that's building the bypass, all this equipment they have invested in this thing, and all the manpower. They really have to put out a lot of investment to take on a project like this. So it helps you understand why it costs so much to build a highway, doesn't it? Here we have a excavator working away back here behind this big boulder, and he is digging up stumps or pulling out roots or something back here and slinging them back around into a pile. Probably going to be creating a burn pile back here. And here we see him take hold of this log, swing it around and add to the pile, gets it out of his way from where he's trying to work. It's amazing watching these things do their thing. Lots and lots of rocks. So the highway's going to be going straight on ahead out that way, back over towards 64. As we swing on around, we see another excavator. On down below here, let's ride on down and see what he's doing. He has a different project underway. You can see they've been working here a little while. You got sort of like windrows of debris pushed up. I believe he could be working on one of these retention ponds or drainage reservoir areas. Catch basin, whatever they're called. I don't know the proper term for them, but at every location, they're building these little small pond-like areas, I suppose, to catch the runoff water or rainfall. And that probably has to do with environmental regulations, I'm not sure. As we study the bulldozer here, looks like to me they're sort of trying to get the dirt out of the wood for burning. It'd be an easy process for him to shove that on up ahead of him, but he's rolling the dirt out of the wood, as you can see there. He's trying to just shake the dirt loose and push the wood debris on ahead, and they will eventually be putting all that into large piles or windrows, or I'm sure they'll be burning most of it. It's going to be a lot of work there ahead of them. Here we're driving on out toward another one. He may be doing the same process or something slightly different. He's over here near the highway. I noticed he has his blade angled So he may just be pushing out a roadway out through here. I'm not quite sure what his agenda is. And we'll take a slow pivot around and see the whole area here that they're working on. Talk about your rocks. They're going to be doing a lot of drilling and blasting to clear all that stuff out, I tell you. As we come back around and cross the highway, you will see where for the last several days they have been doing that exact thing. They have an apparatus there that drills holes down into the solid rock and makes holes, and I suppose what they do is they place charges, like dynamite charges, down into each hole, and then at some appointed time they set them off and blast the rock. There you can see all those little white spots there. That's each of those is a hole that thing has drilled. And on up the top right hand corner, you can see more of it. And on behind that dozer up there, whatever that is, front end loader, that's where they have blasted some out already. I'm not sure when they do their blasting. I don't know if it's during the night time or wee hours of the morning, or I suppose it's probably when there's less traffic. But I've not been by any time that they were actually doing the blasting. That'd be a neat thing to try to get with a drone, but it might be hazardous duty for the drone. Might blow it out of the sky, huh? So here we're looking on south. This is the way the bypass will be going on toward I-73 and swinging on around toward the zoo area, and then finally back around crossing 42 and then all the way on back around to Highway 64 again between Ashboro and Ramsour. This area that you see coming into view now has been cleared off and set up as temporary housing for some of the workers that are on this project. If you look closely, you can see a row of white trailers there. That's where the workers spend their nights. And then the larger buildings there to the right, I'm wondering if that might be their project headquarters. That's just a guess on my part. And now here we swing back, heading back across over the top of the trees here, back toward the Jayco plant. And we'll end the flight up here. Those are there below in the foreground, some more of those ponds for catching the water. I travel this road back and forth at least once a day, sometimes two or three times a day, so I'll keep track of the progress, and I will be updating the videos as progress continues. So I hope you keep checking back for an update. I appreciate your time watching this video, and hope you have a good day. See you next time.